Born Again, head over to Stream 2 if you want to catch them playing. We're dealing with Fnatic here and now, who have always been kind of that hot and cold team. Mm-hmm. But with momentum now on their side, we'll see what they can do with it. It's now going to be Secret who pulls out the Drow Stratwaga as they pick it up first.
Yeah, first pick, definitely worth it as well. They make it work quite well when Secret run Drow Ranger. Envy is very, very comfortable playing this hero. And we will see what Fnatic Mushi is going to react with here. We did see the teams here, of course, gathering around Mushi. And it will be Batrider into Ogre Magi. Got to be the first two.
These have been two of the more popular pickups right now. I don't know how many people have managed to put it into their predictions, but Ogre has been seeing some serious play. I mean, it goes without saying, obviously, we all know this is a real, real fat support right here. Massive armor, massive HP regen. He's able to kind of bully around the lanes, bully around the runes a bit, and in late game has the potential for a lot of lockdown and, you know, a lot of burst.
I think the power of having Ogre is that you know you can protect mid almost better than any other support. So you play against a Mirana or something like that, which is very common right now. Even bounty hunters, Ricky get picks up every now and then Ogre Magi can just sit there, protect your mid laner, and he's gonna be just fine. You can't even kill Ogre Magi even if you went on him with two supports in the early game. So Oracle gonna be the reaction here by Team Secret. They just seem to like playing it. I don't think that's necessarily important that they have it in combination with anything. Of course, Huskar being banned out in the first phase doesn't really offset the fact that Oracle is a strong support on his own.
Obviously offers a great get out of jail free card when you're going against a Batrider too.
Yeah,
I love the idea. We have been theory crafting out of our ears the Morphling hybrid potential, and I'm still anxious to see an Oracle hybrid who happens to have an Agnums with the double instant purifying flames. Just maybe, imagine that. Boom, 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 boom.
Maybe not on official TI games, but I will definitely have to experiment with this myself
in a pub.
Yep. A fun little thing, having that lower cast cooldown.
Nonetheless, he's just one of those kind of high skill cap support heroes, and now when we're seeing him in the hands of these high mechanical players, they can show the new ceilings that these heroes can go for, and we're seeing more Oracle play, and it's getting me excited.
Yeah, and being able to purchase stuff in general is very, very high value. We see a lot of Lotus Orb pickups, a lot of Diffusal, a lot of Yule Scepters, all for this reason. Oracle, he already has two ways to purge stuff built into his hero, so that's really, really good. And of course, the ulti being a strong purge, you can save people from anything with it.
I got to see a little bit of Midwan there. He played a hell of a Shadow Fiend in game number one.
Yeah.
And we'll have to see what kind of hero they're going to be throwing his way. I always like to say, because he was kind of a pub star, you know, when Fnatic brought him in. We actually just recently checked out his MMR. I think he edges just slightly above you, Waga, you know, in kind of that 8k echelon.
Maybe just before it. Wasn't he below me?
Oh wait, you're right.
He's 7.8, man. He's below me.
Oh, but you're right. He's
still
below
a pop star, though.
Yeah, he's not even at your level.
No.
Okay.
He's actually insane. I love his mid play. He just outplays the enemy mechanically a lot, gets a really good control in the lane with the way he pulls the aggro, and that's really what sets apart the great mid laners from the extremely good ones, you know? It's just how you control the lane, how you get the denies, and of course, a lot of playing around the range creep these days. But enough about Fnatic, that, as we see Slark being banned out here by Secret and Axe being banned out by Fnatic. No Axe and Oracle combinations. Pretty strong combo to deal with.
It's been something that Secret have pulled out in the past, even for someone like Puppy to get that 4-position Axe. So Fnatic don't want to deal with any sort of audible call like that. And in the meantime, we'll snag up Milady Mirana there as their third pick. So, more stun to offer, good burst, and a wonderfully scaling hero.
This is a little bit reminiscent of what TNC were doing in a game earlier today, where they played a ton of different stuns together, and that's really what they're setting up here again. Batrider, Ogre Magi, Mirana Arrow. Of course, if they could have a Shadow Demon, they would have loved that hero as well here, and just make the Mirana core. But of course, that's banned out.
Secret. They are sipping the Kunkka Kool-Aid, that's for sure.
They are. They've been watching a lot of these Asian teams bringing in, especially the Chinese support Kunkkas have been amazing. And of course, Puppy not want to say no to playing some Kunkka.
Secure that for themselves. So they got some good setup throughout the laning stage. We see Envy here. Yeah. All performance on Mirana, but it was not going to be good enough. He's been, you know, I have to admit, also a bit hot and cold through this TI6 tournament so far. We'll see him be a bit of a deficit in their laning phase, but then he'll have brilliant moments in these team fights too.
He had that moment when he played Death Prophet and really struggled. We already mentioned it once, but he also had last game where he brought it back from the dead almost, I would say, with the Mirana, getting beautiful kills, blinking in, getting the Abaddon and the Aegis on the Shadow Fiend immediately, following up with a perfect arrow on the respawn. It's just, sometimes he really, really shines as a player. I agree. Sometimes he's just unstoppable, and sometimes he fails a little bit. That's envy, as we know him.
Yeah, very driven, very emotional. Now in a position where he's not kind of the mentor slash leader captain for his team. He can actually lead that, delegate it over to someone like maybe Puppy, and then be able to focus on his own game a bit. So, you know, not too sure where they kind of have been with their formula there, how comfortable they are yet, but they have been finding some middle-of-the-road success so far. So we'll have to see if they continue to blossom or not.
Yeah, I definitely feel that Envy is the kind of player that will bring a lot to the table when you have discussions with your team. I've had the benefit of theory crafting with him a lot of times, and he has great insight. And Puppy is also the kind of captain that he'll make his decision on his own, but he will eat the information from everyone. If you have something to give him, he will work with that and then make his ultimate decision, which he decides really. So I think he's a great captain because of that. He always makes sense of stuff. But here we see Ember Spirit come in as well, so more setup for the arrow, and also a great fighter in the early game. And a great hero to go on Oracle or Drow Ranger, hitting that back line pretty hard.
Yeah, seems like a mid-wand kind of a grab, a flashy kind of a hero that we've already been seeing him play a couple of times, I believe. So something very formidable for him, and more than likely they'll have to round out their lineup with their more carefree, selfless support. But a Storm pops out suddenly.
The Spirit matchup.
I don't think there has been a match yet with all three spirits in the game, definitely not on the same team.
Earth Spirit is forgotten by now. Let's be real. He's not a hero anymore.
When it first came out, everybody was like, he has everything. He's the god of all heroes.
He has OP been nerfed hell. Roughly five or six different patches, though, since then.
Yep.
And in his first tournament, he had some 88% win rate or something. So yeah, he was quite something. But now, not really the top-tier support that we see coming in from, of course, support Mirana, support Kunkka, Ogre Magi, SD. There are many other ones. Elder Titan, who hasn't really been touched in this game and probably won't be touched at all unless it's going to be a core Mirana here.
The team's picking up stuff like all this new buffs and improvements to a lot of the magical resistances, and then, of course, like stuff like raindrops. Can't make it difficult for Earth Spirit to be able to make a good early game impact.
Yeah, I think the nerf that hurt him the most was the lower duration on the roll slow, because that made mid lane a lot harder to gank. And then they also had some terrain changes to mid lane.
The armor on the tower also helps them. The gank, you know, it's like rough.
Getting that level one kill on mid lane by rolling in an orb of venomating, it's not really possible anymore. And that makes his early game unnatural. Mm-hmm. There are some things you can do, though, but I don't think it's as strong as pressuring with other heroes.
We'll have to keep a lookout in the future and see if Earth Spirit will find a new home for himself or not. But back at the actual draft at hand here, final phase of bans. Secret will move the Enchantress, Fnatic rid of the Faceless Void, and Secret will opt for what looks like the Bulba Beastmaster for their final pick in game 2.
Yeah, great disable there. A solid lockdown, and makes it a little bit harder for Ember, since of course he struggles against disables, and now if he stays in the same place for just a little bit, Beastmaster can always just prepare the Kunkka combo, the Storm to jump him, or Drow Ranger to even silence. So he has to be very elusive in his playstyle.
Now, what can Fnatic get here to round out their lineup? One last selfless support, it looks like, to kind of really bring it home.
I don't mind the idea of going Abaddon again, actually. I think the Abaddon worked out really well in the earlier game, and it's not a bad hero here at all. Against Beastmaster, you can remove that stun with a simple Aphotic Shield.
I could also see, I don't know, here comes my crazy bold prediction. It's actually the same hero, Waga. Silencer, maybe, could help against Storm Spirit, could cancel down Oracle. It's a bit crazy and far-fetched. They have plenty of stun already on their team.
They do. I would be...
Who'd have thunk? Alchemist.
Absolutely terrified playing a Silencer against a Storm and possibly Shadow Blade on Drow Ranger and then the Beastmaster Hawk. I would probably sit in my base. But Alchemist should be a little bit bulkier.
That means that it's going to be a support Mirana. So. Yeah. A little bit of a change up there. Wasn't expecting that. And I wonder if Secret were expecting that as a plausible option here, because they're going to be forced into that Alchemist gritty kind of a game.
DJ does love playing the Mirana. I've seen him play it before. And now they also have the possibility to roam towards the Alchemist with the Mirana. And Storm does not like getting focused in the early game. If he gets shut down, I mean, yes, at TI5 we saw some amazing comebacks by Samael and his performances on the Storm. Mm-hmm. But you really want to get your farm in the early game, else it's going to be so tough to get that Bloodstone going, to get the Orchid in a decent time. It's all about timings for Storm.
But what if the timings seem to be good for Secret? Let's say they have a pretty good start to the game. The Storm Spirit isn't pressured too much. Can't they come online with their Drow and really punish Fnatic before their Ember can build up? We know he has a long build up already, and before the Alchemist can really be a big threat.
I think they possibly could, and they could maybe play towards the fact that Alchemist and Ember are both pretty greedy, so they're gonna take a lot of each other's farm. But it comes down to who moves together the earliest and the best. I think both teams could really make the rotations that you're talking about.
See if that's going to be the case here as introductions get underway, an early smoke movement here from Secret to get some cheeky little wards down.
Always the level one smoke and TP out is the meta that we're in, and both teams commit a smoke and a TP, of course.
Secret get two wards to cover pretty much both runes. Fnatic get the one ward in the mid lane to kind of get some extra heads up there.
Yeah, they also have one ward on the Ogre Magi. He was not able to place it down early enough. He was smoked and then he unsmoked, so he didn't want to place it anymore, realizing that the enemy would see his ward. So now he's just holding on to it.
Secret waiting very far back here at this moment. I don't know what kind of casual approach they're going to be. It doesn't look like there's going to be anything too crazy as far as the lane matchup goes.
Do note the TP on Arteezy, ready to TP back and block the creeps.
That value 50.
Of course. Oh, they're gonna go for this rune, and I think they will get it. Begins. We'll see.
It is here now. Pokes Arteezy quite a bit. Arteezy will grab the rune. Is he gonna go for the TP?
Oh, he's not gonna do it because of the... Oh, he's gonna do it, even though they
have
Puppy
now.
Right there.
He's late. Puppy, get it! Oh, they let the range creep through. I guess that works too.
I guess it's still fine, but the better block will be on the side of Mushi, because he's going to get his own high ground, and that's just wonderful for any Alchemist.
All right, and the Alchemist will begin, and obviously touching base on these bounty runes is going to be a big priority for both sides now. And it looks like Ohio, after he, getting a bit ambitious here, moving on in, is going to get the pullback here for the creeps. Puppy continues to he's pump faking this torrent, seeing if maybe he can juke Ohio back a bit into a closer range. But he's going to get the creep wave all the way back and under the tower. 343 will hang by his side as babysitter, and then back and below in the bottom lane, we have DJ, who's going to be side by side with Midwan, who continues to grind out the farm.
Yeah, and right now, he's doing a good job denying the Alchemist a little bit here. Only got one out of the first four CS, in fact. So, of course, didn't get all the denies, but he managed to ruin the CS. And Storm is quite good at shutting out an Alchemist. With the Remnant, you can just walk up and be really bossy. You also have really good armor on Storm.
Yeah,
so
that's where the acid spray can't come in on the other side. So it's definitely tricky for both of them to get close. It's a test of who's got the sustain and who can survive when you get in close quarters for CS.
It is, but at least it's going to be able to stand under acid spray for a bit, whereas most heroes don't have the luxury of 5 armor early on.
True. Mushi actually already down to his last shared Tango, which is on cooldown.
That was so close. If he got the cooldown off just where his Remnant there, he would have killed him, but
denied.
Mushi still walking up, wants to get last hits.
He is
desperately
greedy. Goes in and then quickly needs to pull back and wait for that regen to come back online so he can use it here.
Yeah, Arteezy really doing a good job on the mid lane there. He pretty much won the mid lane from this little play, just pressuring the Alchemist that much. And is it gonna be a suicide by Mushi? Yeah, that's a salve. I'm not sure. No, he's going for the rune.
And it is a bounty rune too. DJ will make sure that it's not going to be contested one bit, so that's a good good swing back there for Mushi.
Definitely. All you need. All you need is an
Alki. Good old Alki. On the other side, though, the other rune was an Invis rune, which Puppy has taken, and he's headed up to the high top lane.
Yeah, I don't think he can do too much.
He can cancel that pull. Ah, pull.
Beautiful.
That actually, you know, it's a little thing, but it affects Fnatic quite a bit. They were hoping to pull the equilibrium back, but now they're going to be forced to kind of hang far forward and be in a scary spot.
For sure. It makes it harder, and that's why Ohio uses Firefly. He wants to go up and push the wave instead. So instead of having it equal, but now he might die for it.
Yes, they will. It looks like there's going to be a Torrent Fortune's End connection, but not enough firepower to get the finish on the Batrider right now.
Tyler Dye could maybe have finished him if he just chased a little bit.
Yeah.
He had one more Purifying Flames. Just anything plus that would have killed him.
A little hesitant, though, and that will allow Ohio to make an escape.
He did have a scary Ogre running at him. I'll give him that.
And an Ogre that big in your face definitely can off-put you quite a bit there.
For sure.
You look at the reflection, though. I mean, Bulba also He's matching up about the same as Ohio in the CS, but he's level 4 now and really not threatened too much.
Mushi is getting destroyed on mid. This is worthy of mentioning again. 6-0 against 21-11?
Ow.
That is crazy. Arteezy's doing a massive job on mid lane. Just really shutting down the Alchemist on his own as well.
Pretty much a full level ahead. You can see the attention towards it now as 343 has approached the area and is hoping to maybe, I don't know, threaten him in some sort of sense. Your best chance of taking Arteezy down is obviously going to be before he gets his level 6. So,
yeah, but since he has his boots and bottle coming out now, Arteezy's going to be pretty good. And the next rune, if he goes to the bottom rune, I think he's in great shape here. So they need some help for the Alchemist. Hope he gets bounty runes. I've definitely seen Alchemists get harder shutdown and then still recover just because of bounty runes. There was that ridiculous game. I was casting with LD at Manila Major, and Alchemist mid got 4 bounty runes in a row, and he was just back. After feeding 2 kills mid, he was back and just in business again.
Typical Alchemist things. So that's the pressure we have currently building up in the mid lane. This is a moment to touch base with what's been happening elsewhere in the world. Mentioned briefly Bulba, who's about level 4.5. Pretty typical buildup for him for now. On this other side, we have Midwan here, who's second in CS, only to that Arteezy Storm Spirit in the mid lane. Poor man shield, 600 gold, 4.5. Things seem pretty steady as they go in the bottom lane there, Waga.
Yeah, nothing really out of the ordinary to expect. And I think Beastmaster is happy. 9-2 in CS. He's getting a lot of experience, level 4. And he's slightly ahead of Ohio, who, sure, he was double laning though with the Ogre. He's sitting around mid.
Gotta give shout-outs to our Ob Scriff, who provides these awesome cinematic-esque slow-posed shots. Pretty awesome.
He's practicing. He's been practicing quite a bit.
It's aesthetically pleasing, and we appreciate it, sir. And, well, as we get back into the grind, Ogre. Secret on the move. Ogre's in the area. Do they see him?
Yeah, they don't really want to reveal that they do see him there. So at first they tried to fake that, oh, we're just going for the rune.
taking a stroll through the woods.
But we do want to kill you as well.
And Puppy is going to be coming in behind the one-on-one.
He's level 1,
the Ogre, though.
He can die to that.
Yeah, Ogre's just like, get over here and starts bopping him in the back. Anticipates the torrent will not be a part of it and pulls off altogether.
Yeah, he has to run away. He's going to be just fine, but you do not man-fight an Ogre one-on-one. I don't care who you are.
We'll have to head back to base in the meantime, and Secret will make the most of his absence.
Denied!
Ohio kind of grinding his way there in the top lane, while 343 rounded the bend here back towards the mid. This is Mushi's chance to hopefully play a little bit of catch up here in the mid lane, where it's definitely proven to be very struggle. It's 14 for him, still to 32 on Arteezy.
Yeah, and Arteezy going to get the help from Puppy here as well with a TPM bottle refill, of course. Going to give it back, and they can go. He has level 6 on Arteezy, but there's a ward. They have just barely seen the Kunkka.
And with X potential later on, we could see some serious shenanigans between Storm Spirit and this Kunkka.
Oh, yeah. You can
That'll
do
be a lot of fun.
Ridiculous stuff. Some aggression by mid one, but
no
not
chains
level 6
connection.
Yet.
Yeah, it looked like he tried to throw out the chains, but couldn't find his target. Or at least couldn't nearly do enough to scare Bulba back and away. He'll be fine for now, and Puppy will just kind of hang close just in case.
Still no first blood, so could erupt on any lane, I feel. But DJ has had a very silent game so far on his Mirana. We haven't really mentioned him much at all, but he's been farming away in jungle mostly and just playing around this Ember Spirit, trying to set up for any kill. Beastmaster blocks off the arrow with his summons. They will throw themselves line of fire.
Do you think this is the best? Okay, there's the jump in commitment. Finds the level 6, shows itself here by Arteezy as he makes a move for the Ogre, and again for the second time straight will strike first for his team.
So much damage as well when he has that Drow Aura. He just hits really, really hard, and he's also out leveling the Alchemist now. Level 7 for 6.
Going back on the note of DJ and his Mirana before something else is to break out, do you think that this was the best use of his time with the laning situation as it was?
I don't think so. I think Ember would have been just as fine on his own against the Beastmaster as with the Mirana's help. I think he should have focused around mid, tried to help out Mushi, because that lane was not easy for Mushi.
We'll have to see if DJ kind of going more in the greedier road pays off for him. I mean, she is...
He'll have the mana boots now if he wants to.
Very high level, you know.
That's going to help him spam out more, and he can go and give mana to the Alchemist so he can keep acid spraying. But yeah, not too sure about this way of using Mirana in the early game.
I mean, Lasso pull back into an early high level of a Starstorm could be nice for an early gank setup. We'll have to see. In fact, she's actually rotated here to the top lane. Let's see if they can land an arrow and make a play here for Fnatic. Yeah. I don't know if Secret can get enticed
to
come
smoke,
too close.
So they're probably gonna Dire's go for the storm, but he's not in the mid. He's farming jungle right now.
Alright, we'll take care of that creep real fast, and then they'll pop the purple stuff.
I do like that he keeps using arrow to kill creeps when they have the time to do it, but I just think he should have focused mid a little bit more.
Has enough mana still for an arrow Starstorm combo. Not enough for a leap quite yet to follow up, but Arcane should be up soon. And now they go on the prowl here in hopes of catching up and spotting out Arteezy, who is close, but he's actually heading out the other way and towards his team.
Yeah, he's actually looking for a kill here, but not going to find it. We'll see if they can connect
here. Oh, he's heading right back toward 343. He's going to walk right into him. Walks right into the stun, into the arrow. Gets shot down. Ohio comes back, and they're going to get the lasso play pullback, and Arteezy goes down. Pilot Eye nearby, but obviously not his level 6 yet. Can't bail him out of the situation.
Wishes he had it. In fact, Mushi finds a little stack here as well.
Ooh, yummy.
That is just the type of stuff that Alchemist wants. The Mud Golems, delicious.
You know what makes this better is after the stack, if that 8-minute bounty rune happened to be at the top lane, wouldn't that just be swell?
That would be swell. Well, guy.
Let's see if that happens to be the case or not, because that could pull Mushi Radiant's right back into a good spot. But would you do, would you look at that right there?
Yeah, that's the comeback mechanic right there, Alchemists. You lost mid? No problem. No problem.
Like
he's now he's ahead by 700 golds here to the storm, but he needs to be ahead by a lot more.
Yeah. Secret bottom lane. Look at them. Thinking about a move. T or Envy smoked up, hiding inside the lane right now.
Good thing that they find Pilot Eye with the illusions, though, so.
Yeah. One is not looking to get caught out whatsoever. Already begins to head all the way back, but Puppy is there, setting down the ward and looking for a play to cut them off. And now they're going to make their move. They set up in, hit him with the Purifying Flames, look to purge it off, but they haven't purged it off yet. They look to go for the X play, but he gets the chains off and jumps back and away. Meanwhile, Arteezy inside the woods here, jump all the way out and across. He's looking
arrow?
To bail out.
Not
yeah, no. Jump into it.
Catch it. He pinged it. He wanted to. But that was at least a good bailout. Nobody dies. And Fnatic, while they do lose a tower, they're starting to farm up a little bit on the Alchemists. The need.
Following with the Alchemist, Ohio has a free lane in the top lane as well. So he can see if he can get his Batrider closer to a Blink Dagger if that's what he chooses.
Sure. And meanwhile, of course, Secret are looking to make something happen here on mid lane.
Be leading in first, hoping for a Torrent X setup. Goes right for Mushi. Arrow flies. Not going to be able to catch him. And now Ohio makes his own jump. Grabs Pylite Eye, pulls him back, looks to take out the Oracle. Bulba makes a move from mid one, connects with the Primal Roar, but then the Remnant away, and Ember makes it out. Now they're looking to go for Bulba here. On the other side, they've been running down Envy, burning him up. The Drow's going to be burnt down. She's gone. On the other side, Bulba also going to be dropped. It's DJ who cleans that one up with Lady Mirana.
Fnatic off to a fantastic start again here. 3-0, and Secret just overcommitting a little bit. That was beautiful grab by Ohio, though. Getting the Oracle, that's just the kind of stuff that you want.
If Secret are not breaking even, I mean, even that's not good enough. They need to be ahead at this point. This Drow lineup is very sensitive to stuff like this.
Well, you need to be ahead in terms of pressure. You don't need to be ahead of the, for instance, Alchemist in terms of net worth. But yes, you need to take control. And losing a fight like that, 3-0, that's definitely going to stump them.
Because then all of a sudden, Secret are going to think that they need to put a lot of attention on someone like the Alk, and you have a mid one sleeping Ember Spirit that could become a big problem, or vice versa. I mean, there's two monsters on the other side of Fnatic who could turn into a problem as this game continues to develop. It could get out of Secret's hands.
Yeah, definitely. And Mirana is also not one to, you know, shy away from farming a little bit here and there. She is trying to get whatever item she needs.
Yeah, she's been definitely taking it in a more of a greedy approach for a support, but it paid off there in the fight. We see a replay now. They
it's
set that, up for Mushi, but...
It's that high-level Starfall really adds a lot of burst damage. He did get the W off before all the magic damage killed him, but Pilot Eye still gets run down in the end. And of course, they couldn't lock down the Ember long enough to really bring him down.
And Envy, who's just a little far from his friends, trying to round the bend or something, ends up on the back end of Mushi and Ohio, and he just gets torched.
Mid one staying alive was beautiful, but top now, Puffy.
Pull back, and he's caught between two. Kunkka, who's just trying to solo farm his way to a level 6, will be brought down a peg, sent back home.
Yeah, and that's 2,150 gold on the Batrider, so he's got to complete the entire Blink Dagger with this. They can now be the aggressors, of course. Bottom tower already under pressure.
Yeah, Secret have been kind of hanging around down here as a three pack for quite a while. Mid one has been forced to play it very passively. I'm sure he's not too happy about that when he would love to continue his farm grind, but eventually looks like he makes a jump up north, and we'll continue to work in the jungle in the meantime. But Secret are not done yet. They know they have this Drow. They know they need to kind of keep the pressure up, and they're moving in for a tier two.
Yeah, they are. They're trying to play around the Auras a lot. Of course, Storm gonna take the top rune. Denying off that bounty rune is pretty important. They need to group up as five, I think, and wonder if they're gonna go for a Rosh attempt here. Secret. They have the Auras. They could try for it. Beastmaster with the Hawks.
All right, they begin to go in. Best bank for Fnatic if they want to spot this one out is maybe DJ scouting it out with an arrow or something, but...
They don't have a smoke, though, so right now it's flying out. They bought it. It's a little bit too late, I think.
Yeah, it is. Rosh is already about half of its life. Fnatic would have to be heading that way right now to catch it.
Yeah.
Two different scans, both of them right inside the pit here.
They're scanning themselves.
They will see a little bit of red, but...
Secret's like, yeah, scan successful. We're looking good.
They get the Rosh down. That's the Aegis. Do Fnatic decide to fight? It looks like they will. Mushi popped up the ultimate here. Envy's going to be able to get the gust up, but then Arteezy makes his move in. Ohio deep in the pit, going to get punished. Is he taken out first and foremost? Meanwhile, Midwan up in arms with Envy and Puppy, looking to take him down while DJ down and below with Mushi by his side. They hope to kind of round the bend with Arteezy, but that's not going to be happening. Double kill for Bulba here and now, and Mushi's got to get the hell out. Well, he say that, but then he makes a move back in. Huge Starstorm comes out from DJ and does serious work across the board on Secret. They're going to be able to quickly take down two. Arteezy's poor little Aegis is already used. They time it out with the arrow, and he goes down. Triple kill for mid one.
Fnatic don't care about anything, do they? They just go in, kill everyone. Oh, Storm has Aegis. We don't really care. We'll just kill everyone.
I thought they were going to just take what they could at that moment and bail out, but they were fighters, man. They went right back in and took it to them. They got it.
I don't know. That's a crazy attitude to just go in like that. And I think of it, a lot of it comes down to Midwan and his aggression. He just went on the Drow Ranger immediately. There was no one to protect the Drow as well, since Ohio was already so deep. But focused down, sure, he didn't get off a good last or anything, but he tanked a lot of spells and died. Mm-hmm. That's all Ohio needed to do in that fight.
So much attention on him, and then Midwan making that jump for Puppy, or
exactly,
not for Puppy, for Envy. Puppy was sitting there like, what can I do about it now?
Yeah, look at Ohio. He's being focused by everyone, but Midwan on that Drow Ranger, chasing her down, and that's what's going to bring her down. And at the same time, who do you kill? Ogre? No, I don't think so. Alchemist? Not really. And DJ managed to run away with a leap. Do bring down the Ogre in the end, but every single resource was expended just to bring down the Batrider and Ogre.
Yeah, bring down the Batrider and then even a committed false promise there to bail Bulba out. And because they're bailing Bulba out, Envy obviously going to be left to his own devices when he's stuck in a matchup against Midwan. Look at mid lane here. Fnatic looking to make their approach under the Moonlight Shadow. They catch up Puppy with a 2x multi, and that's an immediate false promise from Pilai Dai to save his fellow support and captain.
They do think better of it. I was going to ask, is Puppy going to die every time we get out of an instant replay? Because that would be sad for him. But nope, going to get away safely this time.
Good. And above though, Ohio nearby in lane, spots out Arteezy.
Arteezy very close to that Bloodstone. He wants to get it and just have that ready, full mana, and then go for a team fight. Start stacking some blood.
Not really finding too much of a safe place to farm. It looks like Fnatic will be nearby, but they have business in this top lane where they're going to be looking to finish off this tier one. Secret en route to try to split the difference themselves as they head back south.
Yeah, right now I'm just wondering, what will Secret do? They have the Necrobook completed. They saw the Alchemist.
We already have a rotation in from Ohio. They're charging up the stun. The Bulba pullback right here. Mushi waiting with the concoction. Can't unleash it because he's silenced. Beautiful bow, beautiful roar. And that's going to take the Alchemist out. And that's a big bounty swing if they can still survive this fight. But the rest of Fnatic have shown up, and they're going to quickly look to take the move onto Envy, and they are going to get it here. A one-for-one trade, two cores away, but Secret will get the better trade as far as bounty goes.
Oh, definitely. And they also have Arteezy just pushing down mid, so that was fine for Secret. And that's going to be enough to finish the Bloodstone as well. Is under attack. Great way to take the fight. And they kind of baited Fnatic to go on them there, playing towards Fnatic's aggression. That's what I think they have to do. Fnatic is a very, very aggressive team, and you could just set up a little bit, you know, tease them with something, throw Envy in there and be like, hey, come get him.
Bulba gets the last hit on that Alchemist kill, gets him a little bit of a purse, and now he can bulk up a bit more. He's already got the good book, level 1. Gonna get a little bit more though.
Yeah, when he gets that to level 3, it's really, really powerful against some of these heroes. The Batrider with the Firefly, he can't avoid killing the Necrobook. That's a very good way to bring him down. Of course, the Vision is gonna help against the Mirana as well. So it's just multiple ways for this Necrobook to be good. Dire's middle tower
is under attack. And casual send back of Arteezy with the X will get him filled right back up. And back to lane here for Secret. Fnatic have decided to pump the brakes, it looks like, here in the meantime, and will continue their farm build up here. DJ getting his ags could be another huge peaking moment for them.
Mm-hmm.
And Ohio, obviously, a finish off on something like the four staff would be a nice essential tool. All up and above, Mushi and Arteezy. Trading blows here. Pull back, burst, purifying flames, but the ulti of Mushi as he regens right through it all.
Heals so quickly with the armlet and his regeneration from the ulti. But they're gonna try for mid something. They have Eternal Envy and Puppy here. Can't get the X mark though.
Nope.
A little bit too hard.
He is an elusive son of a gun, as mid one will be able to remnant back into his own jungle.
And he's closing up on that Battle Fury, not too far away right now. Perseverance is up, 1100 gold. The Quelling Blade, of course, he has it. He needs the swords now.
And Fnatic are looking for a tier one here in the bottom lane. Good access point to remove, especially if they want to consider contesting Roche themselves in the future. It'd be nice to take that thing out.
It's not too bad to go for a fight if you're Fnatic now. Just group up and play around the Radiance. In fact, the first fight when you finish Radiance, even though Alchemist is not so tanky, it's very hard to bring him down when he has the Radiance. You kind of have to run away with a lot of heroes.
Ooh, look at this. Fnatic have smoked nearby. Envy casually just jungling with his, with his little wolf companion.
Yeah, they ping exactly where he is, but they're also unsmoked now.
Ohio takes to the skies, but it might be a little late if he was hoping to get a catch there for Envy.
Yeah,
could end up crossing
Puppy.
Paths with Puppy, though. Captain Puppy.
Oh, Puppy.
Hi there. Oh, well, it could have been worse for Secret if that was an Envy grab, but Puppy will be the one to tank the gank instead.
But we saw him play a poor Kunkka in the previous game. Hell, he didn't have this much money at the 45-minute mark. So, has fallen. At least at the 40-minute. Well, he'll be fine. He's already got a lot this game.
Mm-hmm.
But Fnatic, though, they're going to be more than happy getting a kill and a tower and still just farming up more. I fear for Secret that this game is slipping out of their control.
I don't know if Secret can really afford to put themselves in a position where they walk away from the series with 0 points. They're already really in the middle of the road as far as their group goes, and if they want to hold on to hopes of making it to the upper bracket, they need to walk away with at least 1 point here.
That's what it comes down to. If you're fine with lower brackets, then you can, but...
I don't think anyone's fine with going through that gauntlet in that best of one area.
It's not the best of fun. And also, of course, money is at stake. If you just go into the upper bracket, you will already be securing more prize money for yourself.
Oh, that's for sure. Secret now on the move, smoked up. Puppy leads in, gets a nice little aggressive ward here to see if they can get some advanced vision. But yeah, as mentioned, Fnatic ping that area and posture up on the other side. That way Secret would have to approach them from the lower ground and in a very volatile position.
Yeah, and right now just the farm cam as Alchemist is farming up.
Blam, blam, farm cam. It's exciting.
He's cut the travels, dude.
Get that.
I'm excited.
Get that dragon. Radiant's middle tower. Tower down though, Arteezy. We'll be able to get the last nod there in the mid lane. Decides to pull back and out. As here comes Fnatic charging down confidently into Secret side of the map.
It feels like Secret, now they're trying to build on Fnatic's aggression and just setting up traps, but right now they need to pressure and get more towers down. Because you're against an Alchemist, you're against an Ember, and even the Mirana at this point is getting so much farm. I feel like they need to turn up the heat.
Looked like maybe they were going to be doing a casual tier 2 trade, but Secret take towers still very, very fast. They get that tier 2 in the bottom lane, and they begin their move right towards potential high ground territory here on the bottom. If Fnatic don't get back and get ready to prepare for a defense, first Sleight of Fist will fly out from mid one. Does slow the roll a bit here from Secret.
That bloodlust the tower, though, hitting so fast.
Very true. Oh, long grab here. Pull back for Arteezy in the top lane. Mushi pulls back, can't get the stun off. He's locked in place. The Torrent's going to keep him there. The boat will shift. It will sail. It will land right onto Mushi. He will be able to shrug that one off. Here comes mid one now. Latches down onto Puppy, and that seems to be the end of it. No bloodshed.
No one's going to go down in the end, and the farm war continues, but Secret did get a tower on bottom lane, so they're starting to do what they need to do. Minimize the map that Fnatic can play on. Getting rid of these towers is really crucial. If they can find a D-ward as well on this high ground, I don't know if they can D-ward that. That's actually just barely not seeing it. Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Just out of range there, so... Fnatic will be able to maintain a little bit of offensive vision on that front and scout the farming patterns here of Secret and where they look to go. while Fnatic can continue their grind up. It looks like Ohio has finished off his ruby red shoes. He actually went for the boots of Travel Waga before finishing out the usual Batrider tool belt of a four staff to follow that.
With the Bloodlusts, I understand that. Look at his movement speed. Bloodlust 475 movement speed. It's insane.
He's a flying race car.
He really is. So I don't think you need to go four staff first in this game, but I think he should go back to it though. Four staff is great against Beastmaster and also against Storm. Just pulling away whoever he tries to lock down.
Roche is back up, and obviously there's going to be a lot of tension around this pit. Both these teams really want to get it here. But imagine especially Secret.
No.
Fnatic, hang in the neighborhood, but it's Secret who smoke up and begin to prowl. Envy hangs back in the lane, but the rest of his team wrap around and let Puppy lead out the front to see if he can get a catch. But Fnatic already pulling back quite a bit.
Yeah, Secret are looking for anything, but of course, this should be known by all. 347? Or
okay, there he is. There's the Ogre. Moonlight Shadow's going to come out. We'll probably be tanking the gank on this side of things. Not the worst thing in the world, the fatty Ogre. Fatty gank.
Yeah, definitely. And they're going to go for Roshan. Very quick Roshan with the Draw Ranger. Mixing up 3-4-3 with 3-5-7.
1-4-3-7, 3-4-3.
Yep. There's a lot of numbers in Dota. Maths.
RTZ and company make their move inside the pit. Fnatic only down their Ogre. We'll see if they want to still make a defense. DJ hanging around, not shooting an arrow into the pit quite yet, but has it up now.
Well, they're going.
And they are going to begin to make their move for it. The arrow sails, connects, takes out the Necrobook, jumping from Ohio, gets the last one, trying to get the pullback, but quickly Pylight Knight will bail. Promise, Mighty Sky Storm walls out, a boat to sail to help out with the run, but it might not be good enough. It's Fnatic taking serious blows, but here comes Mushi mid one, the power hitter for Fnatic. Secret could be in trouble here, but Arteezy's back in action now, jumps into the lower pit, looks to go for mid one, looks to pull him out, steps on the outside here, and jumps quickly out to safety. Not a fight Secret we're anticipating, it looked like, because Fnatic came in and they hit hard.
Man, Fnatic just run in like bosses when they go in. The Mirana had to leap in there. She got tons of damage done as well with the Aghanims. Sadly for her, she did go down. And of course, if Storm didn't grab that Aegis, that could have been game right there. Like, actually so decisive that he got the Aegis grab. RTZ.
We'll see a replay of the fight.
Looking mid.
It broke down.
Didn't get the grab on mid one.
I think he'll be fine. We see though, as the Roche fight breaks out, Ohio gets that lasso. It quickly gets canceled though.
Then you see the buddies just run in.
Yeah, look at this. Like, let's go in and let's do work where Mirana left it for us, and they just went to town.
Poor Envy. Being a small drow in that scenario is not fun.
No, not at all. He still continues to trail, but only level 12 this point in the game. Falls behind quite a bit. 10k above him is the Alchemist, way up there at the top. 3k in his pocket. What's up? He is turning into that pseudo Naga style alchemist pretty fast. And then the Ags begin to roll out.
He's about to get that Octarine. When you get Octarine and just one more item, then you can start building. Oh!
X is here on Arteezy as he just makes an ambitious jump while down and below. They get the lasso pullback and will take out Captain Puppy.
The X almost worked against him there. He had to time his ball lightning so he can't get pulled back. Wow. That was quite something.
Man, what started it as a cheeky little harassment play from Puppy?
I think RTC was not happy with the X, like, right there. He's like, you died? How are you gonna, leave
and
me
And then, of course, it lasts so long on your allies. Yeah. He's like, I gotta wait for it to cancel so I can get the hell out of here.
Yeah, that was some dangerous stuff for RTC on this storm. But he keeps his 15 Bloodstone charges safe. That jump away. It should probably look to fight mid.
Here comes Fnatic, knocking at tier 2s. Mid one sport and that fresh Battle Fury, Yasha on hand, and they begin their assault. Once Mushi begins to go to work, then the real...
They're stacking heals on Arteezy right now.
Bat maxing up his regen as much as possible just before his jump, which is now makes his move, and then goes right back out. But he goes right towards 3-4-3, who pops him with the stuff. Meanwhile, Ember Spirit gets the quick snip, taking out the Kunkka, and Arteezy hops right back towards the safety of his base.
Man, they cannot hold that tier 2 tower, and they're gonna look towards the bottom lane, where there's even a tier 1 tower waiting for them. Just bags of gold right now if you're Alchemists. So much money on him as well. He can buy the entire thing. I'm not sure why he keeps an empty bottle at this stage. We should just sell and get the entire Octarine, but maybe he wants to buy back gold. I don't think that matters this early, though.
And a bounty. one.
All right, he'll get it anyway. Popping the bounty rune, he'll have his Octarine complete.
Very nice. And, well, he's going to become even more scarier than anticipated before by Secret. We look to Secret now, Waga. Mm-hmm. What are they going to have to do now to be able to kind of get some room back on their side, get some farm? And, you know, when you look at their option as far as pulling out the late game and where the damage is going to be coming from, do they even have that?
I think they need to have really perfect executions from here on, because they're so far behind against an Alchemist and Ember. You just need to combo perfectly. The Drow Silence has to be on point as a follow-up. After a Beastmaster Storm go, here goes Storm.
He's trying to get a hold of the backliners here. He's trying to get a hold of mid one, actually, and is able to burst him down fast enough. The follow-up from Bulba as he gets the roar off. Mushi, though, stands, and he is the raid boss here, and he's happy to truck on forward, flexing that new Octarine core. Nice dodge right there with the help of the Manta, but he's still going to get caught up from the Torn, from the boat. Hits him in his spot. Envy tries to unload the right-click damage, but he does get hit with the stun right there, and Fnatic quickly flee.
Yeah, they have to run away. Storm is also respawning. He's coming back.
X is there, grabs on the DJ, he shoots out the arrow before he's hit with the torrent. 343 says, take me instead! Runs right into Secret to slow them down.
Still a pretty good fight by Secret there. Of course, dying with the storm really hurts, and buybacking the Kunkka as well, they did have to pay a little bit for that. I still think it's worth it. And they also showed the strength that the Orchid brings.
We're not done yet, Ohio. Snags out Puppy. Puppy gets bailed out. Nice little false promise. Artesia showed up, jumps in, and look at this. It's going to turn into a Secret pick as they take down Ohio.
The gem. Gem goes the way of Secret now. Got to be more than happy to have that on Storm. Very easy to get some D wards.
Fnatic simply thought they were going to have a quick and easy pick with Pylodi nearby. That's not so easy.
And then we see the TP the base and refill with X mark. Storm is going to be back to full mana as well. Good stuff. But this game reminds me a lot about the previous game as well. Fnatic with the strong control in the early game, and then come back by Secret. They're gonna try mid, maybe? Secret?
Jump in, there's the Orchid, but it's gonna be Manted off this time for mid one. There's the pull, though, with the boat coming in. Not gonna connect, he's able to remnant and make it out.
Too damn slow, this ship. Cannot get there in time. Trying to land the combo, very difficult one to land, in fact. That Manta style will keep him safe on mid one.
Sets him back, and items beginning to trickle in. I just can't help though but feel like Fnatic's scaling late game is just so much more scarier. Ags are going to begin to trickle out here from Mushi. The Ember is going to start bringing in something like a Daedalus, and
all the Aghanims as well. Yeah, it's going to be the Aghanims are going to be the big part, I think, because right now the Shivas is being completed by Mushi, and that's going to be the final item that he buys for himself for quite a while, I believe. He could, of course, get rid of the armlets and upgrade that to anything else. But I think at this point, you just look to Ogre and say, hey man, you want that unrefined blast? Pretty good.
It's a standard good Alchemist game. When you jump into a game, you're like, oh, I'll spectate this Alchemist game. And you see the net worth and it looks like this. Things are looking pretty good for the Elk when he's just miles what feels like above everyone else.
He's 11,000 ahead of the second guy, and that guy is on his same team.
That's
crazy. You're in a great position right now if you're Fnatic. But we did see what happened in the last fight. They can definitely be taken down. Yeah.
With great power comes great responsibility, Waga. Mm-hmm. You have so much net worth behind you, and if you hand it over to the other team, that's what
you're gonna say. Comes great feats.
With great power comes potential for great feats and great entertainment.
I've seen stuff like that. They're gonna probably get this tower without contesting.
That's Secret's last outer tower too. Until it's all high ground from here.
And it's not long until Roshan is gonna potentially be up again, so a little bit scary for Secret, giving up this tower.
Best thing is that Fnatic don't have that new gem, so they can't quickly just scavenge out and take out any sort of exterior wards here by Secret. Do they have a gem available? Jump in.
Mushi is going. He doesn't care about anyone.
He really doesn't. Thinks he's mighty enough, sidesteps the torrent, and goes right back into this tier 3.
I mean, he did 1,100 damage onto that tower in one single push. That's really good preparation. Something that I think not a lot of people value in Dota is just preparing for your final high ground push. That tower is already so low HP, it's going to be very easy for them next time they get there.
And Fnatic have not pulled off at all. Still hanging around with only mid one sent to the top lane to kind of cover the pressure there, but now he's back and Fnatic going to make a move in, looking to walk away with a surprising 2-0 over Secret here. Jump in from Arteezy to rid of the creeps.
That TP, yep.
Goes all the way back now. They do have the X. They can do more of these shenanigans of storm jump in, clear out the wave, send them back to the fountain.
And I believe they will and need to. We'll see if Puppy and Storm are going to set up for it. But maybe Fnatic just back off and buy up some items here. They have a lot of gold to spend. But they seem like they want to keep pushing.
It's a little bit of a longer timer on the Roche, so Fnatic will have to wait a bit. So the slow siege just continues here. They get that tier 3 down. Bushi begins to go to work on that precious melee Racks. Silenced up. They got to begin to do something here. Envy's getting the heals here by the Oracle. Midwan makes his jump, gets off the chains in the slight, does some good work. Envy down to half of its life, pops the BKB. There goes the roar back. Midwan locked in place. Beautiful setup there from Secret with the boat follow up. He gets blown up.
But the Racks is gone though. They got what they came for. Sure, you lost Midwan, but everyone else seems to be getting out just safe. And since Roshan has a long respawn time, that means the Midwan probably will respawn before Roshan can be taken.
Yep. Secret will try to head their way there. But quickly getting these waves pushed out, and then we'll begin to migrate to that area. But as you mentioned,
sad news. Yeah.
Roshan won't be up, and
not quite yet.
Midwan will be back.
And this is the time when Alchemist can really look to. He's going to eat a Moonshard before he gives anything. He gets pinged out by Midwan.
Greedy.
And by Lasso, or and by Ohio.
Greedy.
I think his team is calling him out on
what
this.
Are you doing? Give me an axe, you fool.
Where's the axe?
What are you doing, Moonshard boy?
Yeah. You need Moonshard?
Ohio's like, dude, I can lasso too. And then 343's like, dude, I could just unrefined fire blast, man.
I like how Midwan is done to call him out as well. He's like, I can't even get upgraded, but you should still buy Aghanim.
He's like, give me stats.
Yeah, that's true. A little bit of tankiness for Ember. Who doesn't want that?
Right click and extra DPS for sieging looks to be the idea here for Mushi.
Man, Mushi the greedy one. It's all about him.
He'll pass though.
He will hit fast. The Bloodlust, the ulti.
Bloodlust Moonshard.
Yep, and the ulti popping off, he will hit like a monster. Already has pretty fast attack speed. That's without ulti.
I like how 343 was like, I'm not going to give you the Bloodlust. I'll just throw it on mid one, and if it happens to multicast your way, then fine.
Yeah. You'll get to spill all the Bloodlust. That's what you deserve now.
Okay. Advantageous roar needed from Bulba. Secret trying to take a fight deep past enemy lines. Now there's no roar to even worry about.
I'm not sure why. Yeah, okay. I guess he didn't see them at all. He was just very far out, though, with the Beastmaster.
That was intimidation factor right there, I think.
Yeah. I'm not sure. That will be a free Roche, it seems, for Team Fnatic. Definitely a costly death there.
Illusion. All right. Fnatic move in after a successful little Beastmaster pickoff. And we'll look to claim the Roche. Will Secret have an answer for it? Does not look like it.
See that attack speed.
Maybe an ambitious jump from Arteezy here. Grand Theft Aegis, one can only dream.
Yeah,
he's going for it. Long X jump inside. Roche is still
alive. Take me out of here.
Get me up, buddy.
Get me out.
Jumps up to the high ground. He made the jump out. That was too close. I don't know if they want to make that kind of play again.
He was jumping around when the X triggered. So he couldn't get pulled back.
Keys and Aegis hit the deck. Immortality. And Fnatic will snag both of them up. Ember will be the one to take the Aegis, it looks like. And then the cheese will be handed over to DJ.
Surely Mushi will go for tier 2 boots instead of buying an Aghanim's now.
Oh, he absolutely.
He's not gear capped yet, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The teammates, they don't deserve this net worth.
He's like, I got the Moonshard so I can farm your Ags faster. Duh.
That's the kind of stuff I would tell my teammates. Oh, we see Secret here.
Nearby, Arteezy looking to posture up. They make the jump in, looking to go for Ohio to get the York and the Axes through, and they'll take him out. Meanwhile, in the meantime, they're able to take out Puppy, so it's a one-for-one trade. Bulba going to get quickly taken out next, and Mushi's on a tear. Gets the chains connection, Envy, you're not going anywhere. Gets taken down. He is out over 1 minute without a buyback.
Oh no, two of them with no buyback as well, and they're right at the doorstep.
Bulba has one more Primal War and a Necro 3 to help with this defense, but it might be just too much from the side of Fnatic here.
Yeah, it really might be. This Alchemist is not going anywhere.
Mushi's in, tier 3 is down. Secret on the verge of losing another set of racks here and losing this series 0-2 without taking a win. Midwan begins to move in, looks to go for the Arteezy in the back inside to get silenced up. Midwan will lose his Aegis, but Mushi's the one doing all the damage. He's just taking out the racks in the mid lane. And now looks to go for the top.
DJ on the sideline, so picked up the Beastmaster as well after his buyback.
This is over. Fnatic are moving in. They got the Magus. Game has been called. Fnatic pull out the upset as they 2-0 Secret.
Beautiful play, and Fnatic, I did not expect them to go in a 2-0. I thought maybe a 1-1 series could come out, but Secret, they got completely taken by this. And Fnatic, they're really strong in the early game. That's one thing that I take away from the series.
Mid one with the excited pings. He doesn't look excited in camera, but this has been a big boost for Fnatic. They still kind of reside.